Every second you keep lying.
Something wrong?
No, I just never noticed that scar before, that's all.
Stop talking.
Don't you get it?
Boyhood misadventure. Fell off a fence. No. Compound fracture. Hence the scar.
Oh, I just remembered an errand I forgot to run. You gonna be okay on your own for a while?
Somehow I'll soldier on.
Let's take a minute. Belle, let's go.
I was wondering if you could help me. Alistair.
Miss Watson. A surprise. But if you're here for an encore performance...
I know you're not just some actor Sherlock hired. You know him.
He engaged me through my representation. I'd never even seen
him. That story you told me, the one about his broken wrist, it was true. He would have never shared that with you if you were just some actor, especially not to play some stupid prank.
How did you find me, if you don't mind me asking?
The receipt you dropped. It had the name of this bookstore on it. You got a 20% discount, members get 10. I realized you must work here.
You've been spending quite a bit of time with him, haven't you?
Yeah, I really am an actor, you know. In London, I had a small part in a radio drama. Yeah, we still have those across the pond. Sherlock wrote me a letter when he was 10, saying that I alone, of all the cast, truly captured the Yorkshire accent. Yeah, I thought it was odd. But I was also very flattered. So eventually we met, so I could coach him on his nuances. We became friends.
Sherlock doesn't have friends.
Not in the traditional sense. He drops in and out. Appears at odd moments to make outrageous and highly specific requests.
Respectfully, that doesn't sound much like a friendship to me.
Then perhaps you'd better revise your definition. You can't expect Sherlock Holmes to relate to you the way others might. The moment you do, he'll migrate out of your life and you'll be the poorer for it. You do realize that, don't you?
He told you about me, right? You know what my job is?
I do. And for what it's worth, I'm very glad he has you.
You knew him when he was using?
After I first came here in 06, we mostly kept in touch by email. I knew he was dabbling on and off, but I was confident that he would grow out of it. 9 months ago, he shows up at my flat at night, so high he could barely speak. Well, I flushed his drugs and I looked after him for a day or so. It was very difficult for me to see his mind so addled. He could barely stay conscious. And when he kept muttering the same name again and again.
What name?
That doesn't matter. I asked him about it the next morning. He assured me it meant nothing.
Did you believe him? Look, I want to help him. But I think you know how difficult that can be. I thought if I could talk to you, that maybe you could help me get a better sense of what to do. Anyway, thank you for your time. I'm sorry if I bothered you.
Miss Watson, I have a strong suspicion that that name meant more to him than he claimed. I think perhaps you should have it.
I take it you made your case against Charles Cooper?
The police made the case. I just lent a helping hand. An enormous helping hand. But still. What is it? You look peculiar.
I guess there's a question I want to ask you. About your past.
Excellent. You wait here. I'll go to my room, shut the door. As soon as you're absolutely certain I can't hear you, ask away.
I know about Irene. I want you to tell me about her.